She has fought in the Persian Gulf and in the war against drugs. The USS Crommelin served nearly 30 years in the Navy, and today she was honored with a decommissioning ceremony. Manola Morales reports.
Members filed out of the Perry-class guided missile frigate as part of the decommissioning ceremony at Pearl Harbor. For the crew of about 120 sailors, this day is bittersweet. They will no longer hear the hum of her engines out at sea, but the crew is also looking forward to the next chapter in their military career.
The lifeblood of the ship is the crew, and it's going to be sad to see them go, but they're all moving on to bigger and better things, I think. They'll take the skills and knowledge they learned here, hopefully, and make their next ship or their next station a better place.
The USS Crommelin is named after three brothers who served in the Navy and were hailed as heroes during World War II. Two of them died in battle. She was first commissioned back in 1983 in Seattle, and as the first commanding officer remembers it, one of the most powerful ships of its kind.
This ship was beautiful. She ran as well in the trough as she ran going into the sea, or even better.
In 1991, Pearl Harbor became the home port for the USS Crommelin. She served several deployments in the Persian Gulf and has also battled in the war against drugs. In 2004, her crew intercepted more than 20 tons of cocaine worth more than $1 billion. In recent years, the Crommelin has served mainly in anti-submarine warfare in the Pacific Ocean. So what happens now that the U.S. Navy no longer needs her services? She'll likely be sold and serve another country.
That's typically what it'll do, and it'll be brought back to life in another Navy.
Manolo Morales, KHON2 News, Hawaii's news leader.